वेलकम टू द 18th लेक्चर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एंड मैनेजमेंट। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल टॉक अबाउट अ न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज जॉब कॉस्टिंग। बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद दिस टॉपिक, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन अबाउट डबल एंट्री बुक कीपिंग। वी हैव टेकन टू लेक्चर्स ऑफ डबल एंट्री बुक कीपिंग। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट विथ सम कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिमेनिंग अबाउट डबल एंट्री बुक कीपिंग एंड अकाउंटिंग। We will cover that and then we will talk about job costing. So these are the topics that we are going to cover. Generally accepted accounting principles, accounting conventions, job costing, some documents, job cost record or job cost sheet or job order. What are general entries? Accounting for factory overhead, overhead budget, product costing in non-profit organization, product costing in service organization, and activity-based costing in non-profit and service organization. So as we have seen in double entry bookkeeping or in accounting, so accounting is not a science. It is not just a science. It is an art. So accounting is more an art than a science. And it is not based on any scientific concepts. It is based on some set of principles which are there, which are dependent on some general agreements, which agreement is approved by some number of accountants, right? And these are not rules which are proved. So it is a set of principles on which there is a general agreement and not on rules that can be proved. So GAAP are made up of accepted accounting practices on conventions, rules and procedures. So these are some conventions, rules and procedures which are accepted by some accounting community. These are not scientific, right? So there are few accounting conventions. So first is continuity or going concern convention. The meaning of this is that whenever we are doing accounting of any firm or entity, so we are going to do accounting of that firm until and unless that firm is exist, right? When that firm get vanishes, then we won't do accounting or we won't keep entries of that firm. So continuity means unless and until that entity is present, we have to do accounting of that entity. For example, firm or organization. There are so many reasons that firm or organization get vanishes, but until and unless that firm is exist, we have to do accounting of that firm. Next is objectivity or verifiability. So acquisition cost is more verifiable than a replacement cost or a resale cost. Whenever we are talking about any accounting system, we are going to consider the acquisition cost of any product or acquisition cost of any service. We are not going to consider the resale cost, because resale cost is cost that we are going to consider that after selling this product we will get this amount, but that is not sure. The amount can change. So if we want to get exact results, we are going to consider acquisition cost. Next is materiality. So minor items with small values are assumed to be consumed within a year are expensed off. Whenever we are going to considering accounting, we are not going to keep account of small things. For example, if there is any firm and that firm ordered a ream of papers, right? They order 2 reams of paper. So that is a very small amount as compared with that firm. So we are not going to keep account of that thing. Or if any firm buys 2 boxes of pens, then that is very small amount. So we are not going to keep account of that pens. So minor items with small values are assumed to be consumed within a year are expensed off. And obviously that number of pens they will use it for a year. They won't use it more than a year. Or that ream of papers will be useful for 1 year, right? That won't stay alive more than 1 year. So this is materiality. Next is conservatism. So inventory is valued at a cost or market value, whichever is lower. So whenever we are talking about inventory that we are going to use, it will be valued depending on two cost. First is the actual cost, or second is the market cost of that inventory. So whichever will be the lower, if the valued cost is lower, then we are going to consider that, or if the market value is lower, we are going to consider that. The next is cost benefit criteria, whether to have the accounting system in the ERP. So there are types of accounting system, whichever to use, it depends on cost benefit criteria. Next is recognition, the accrual basis rather than cash basis. We have talked about accrual basis in last lecture. So recognition will be done on the accrual basis rather than a cash basis. Matching and cost recovery, linking revenues with expenses, assets are carried forward to recover cost of these assets in the future. So it's very simple, if you read it carefully you will understand it. Next is stable monetary unit. So in stable monetary unit, inflation is generally ignored. So whenever we are considering accounting system, inflation is ignored. Inflation means increasing price of the product. Now we will talk about job costing. So job costing is either applied to a specific job or a single physical unit or a batch of job. For example, if we are producing a single unit of any product, we will apply job costing to that single unit, or if number of products are produced into a group, then we will apply job costing to a job lot, or we can say batch. It is relevant to tailor-made goods like manufacturing industries such as construction, printing, furniture, specific machinery, etc. Next is source document. So for making job costing, source documents are required. There are two types of source documents. First is direct material requisition and second is labor time tickets. So direct material requisition means what? We are going to keep record of materials issued to particular goods. So whatever goods we are going to produce, the material required for making that goods, we are going to keep record of that material. And the fields that we are going to keep for that particular material are requisition number, job number for which job the material is used, date, department, in which department that particular good is created and that material is used, then description about the material, quantity, how much material we are going to requisite, unit we are going to produce or unit cost, and the amount required to buy that material. And second source document is labor, that is time ticket or time cards. So time ticket means what? A record of the time a particular direct employee spend on each job. So whatever time particular employee is spending on job is known as a time ticket. So fields that we are going to use are time ticket number, employee number, in which department the employee is working, date, on which date the employee has worked, start time of the employee, end time of the employee, hours spent on that particular job, rate of working, amount and job. So total hours, total time and supervisor, who is a supervisor. So these are the source document that we are going to use for making job costing of any product. Now job cost record or job cost sheet or job order. It is summarizes information contained in a source document. So we know what is source document. There are two source document. First is time ticket and second is material requisition. So whatever information there is a source document, that will be summarized as each job begins, its job cost record is created. So whenever job is started to build, its job cost record is created, means its source documents are summarized as unit are worked on and entries are made for each and everything. Entries are made for each job in department are, so what are the entries that are going to be made into the job cost record are direct material cost, direct labor cost and budgeted overhead cost. And the fields that we are going to enter into a job cost record are department, date started, date completed, job number, units completed, direct material description, date, reference, quantity and amount, subtotal direct material, direct labor description, date, reference, quantity, amount, subtotal direct labor, फैक्ट्री ओवरहेड अप्लाइड, डेट, क्वांटिटी, अमाउंट, सब टोटल ओवरहेड, टोटल कॉस्ट एंड टोटल यूनिट. नाउ दिस इज द एग्जांपल. सो डीएम इज डायरेक्ट मटेरियल, वीएल इज डायरेक्ट लेबर, इनडायरेक्ट रिसोर्स कॉस्ट आर देयर. There are two jobs, job 1 and job 2. VIP is work in progress, and so job 1 work in progress and job 2 work in progress. Direct material and direct labor is different for job 1, and direct material and direct labor is different for job 2, while indirect resource sources are common for job 1 and job 2. So here we are using T account. XX and XX are shown amount in debit and amount in credit. So whenever that job is finished, so job 1, which is in blue color, so job 1 will be completed. When work in progress will get completed, that will get transferred to cost of total goods sales, right? And again it will get converted for job 2 into cost of total goods sale. So in this way the it happens. Direct material, direct labor is used for job 1 and job 2, which is work in progress, and that amount will get transferred into cost of goods sales. So red line shows flow of resources and blue line shows flow of cost data. So in this case, pay attention here. Direct material purchase, so we are having direct, we have purchased a direct material, the cost is 1900, right? The cost is 1900. For direct labor, the cost is 390, and fixed overhead, the cost is 392. Now, out of 1900, we have make purchase of 1900, but out of 1900, we are using only 1890. So we are using it 1890. So in work in progress, the direct material is 1890. For direct labor, the cost is 390, and we are using it all the cost, right? So direct material requisition for manufacturing is 1890. Means out of 1900, the requisition cost is 1890. And fixed overhead is 392, out of which applied is 375. So rupees 375 of fixed overhead is applied. So the total of 1890 plus 390 plus 375, it will be 2500, right? So 2500. So that 2500 will get converted into final goods inventory. That is, we have made a final goods inventory of worth rupees 2500, and out of which cost of goods sales is, we have made product of worth rupees 2500, out of which we have sold it of rupees 2480. So cost of goods sales is 2480. Now the balance into the final goods inventory was 12 rupees, right? The balance into final goods inventory was previously 12 rupees. Now we have made a product of worth rupees, or cost of goods sales made and transferred to final goods inventory is 25,000, that is 2,500, and we have sold, the cost of goods sales is 2,480, so there is a difference of rupees 20, so 20 plus 12, so your balance will become 32, and here in this case, the fixed overhead is 392, out of which you have applied 375, so 17 rupees are under applied. 17 rupees are under applied. So again in this case, all the figures are in 1000. I am saying here 17 rupees, but these are in 1000. So 17 rupees are under applied. So I hope you understand it. Now general entries. So direct material purchased rupees 1900000 on credit. So direct material inventory, that will be in debit account, and accounts payable will be on credit account. Now direct material requisition is 1890000. So work in progress inventory will be that much, and direct material inventory will be written on credit account. Direct labor cost incurred is 390,000, remains unpaid. So work in progress inventory, that will be on debit side. So 390,000 will be on debit side, and accrued in inventory 390,000 will be on credit side. Again here, factory overhead incurred is 392,000. So factory department overhead control will be on debit side, 392,000, and cash account payable etc. will be on credit side, that is 392,000. Factory overhead applied rupees 375,000. So work in progress inventory will be on debit side, and it will be 375,000. And direct material inventory will be 375,000, which will be on credit side. Cost of goods completed rupees 25,000. So final goods inventory will be on debit side, and work in progress inventory will be on credit side. Sales on account rupees this much, and account receivable will be on credit side, and account receivable will be on debit side, and sales will be on credit side. Cost of goods sold worth rupees, so that is we have seen 2,40,000. So that will be cost of goods sales will be on debit side, and final goods inventory will be on credit side. So accounting for fixed overhead. So whenever managers require a fixed overhead or actual overhead that is not available with them, so they use budgeted overhead cost, right? So actual overhead are not available when managers need them, so budgeted overhead costs are used. So how to calculate budgeted overhead rate? So it will be calculated on the basis of budgeted total overhead and budgeted cost driver. It is depend on both the values. So fixed overhead will be applied. It depends on budgeted overhead rate and actual cost driver. So there is a difference. So find the difference between the applied fixed overhead and the actual factory overhead to determine the amount under and over applied factory overhead. So let's see overhead budget. Overhead in the two departments consist of indirect labor, supplies, utilities, repairs, factory rent, supervision, depreciation, insurance and property tax. So there are two departments, one is machining and second is assembly. Now budgeted overhead for machining is 277,800 rupees, and for assembly it is 103,220 rupees. Now cost driver for machining is budgeted machine hours, and cost driver for assembly is budgeted labor hours. Now budgeted cost driver value is 69,450 machine hour cost driver value, and budgeted cost driver value for assembly is 206,400 direct labor hours. Now how to calculate overhead rate? That will be 277,800 rupees, that is budgeted overhead divided by budgeted cost driver value, right? So that will be 4. So that will be your overhead rate. Now, how to calculate overhead rate for assembly? It will be again budgeted overhead divided by budgeted cost driver value, right? So that will be 0.5. Now, actual cost driver values are given, which are 70,000 machine hour, and actual cost driver value 190,000 direct labor hours. So budgeted overhead is given, budgeted cost driver value is given, and actual cost driver value is given. On the basis of budgeted overhead and budgeted cost driver value, we are going to calculate overhead rate, right? And depending on that, we are going to calculate applied overhead. So now you know overhead rate, that is 4 and 0.5 respectively for machining and assembly, and actual cost driver values 70,000 and 190,000. So applied overhead will be 70,000 into 4 and 190,000 into 0.5. So that will be 280,000 and 95,000. So total overhead applied will be 280,000 plus 95,000, that will be 375,000. Actual overhead will be 392,000, and overhead under applied will be 392,000 minus 375,000, that is rupees 17. So this is how it is calculated in this case. See this example. In this case, the overhead actually is 392,000 and applied is 375,000. So 392 minus 375, that is 17, that is under applied. And how this 392 and 375 is calculated, that we have seen here. Given upon budgeted overhead, budgeted cost driver value and overhead rate. Now, disposition of under applied or over applied overhead. There are two methods, immediate write-off to cost of goods sold and proportion among inventories, that is assigning in a proportion to the size of ending, work in progress, financial goods, inventory and cost of goods sold. So work in progress is 155,000, that is see here we are continuing this example. Work in progress is given, right? Balance VIP is 155. Work in progress balance is 155. So final goods 32,000. So 32 balance was remaining. The previous balance was 12 rupees, and there was a difference between actual goods made of worth rupees 25,000 and sold was 2480. So difference was 20. So 20 plus 12, that was 32,000. And cost of goods sold is 2480. That is also given. So proportion of under applied overhead. 155, that is work in progress balance, divided by 2667, that is total of this all. Total of 4890 plus 390 plus 375. So that is into 17,000, that is under applied overhead. So that will be 998 for work in progress. For final goods it is 204, and for cost of goods sold it is 15808. So that will be total 17,000, and adjacent balance will be, if you calculate it in total, 155,000 plus 998, that will be 155,988. 32,000 plus 240, so that will be 32,240. And 2,480,000, so that will be 2,00,000 plus 15,808, so that will be 2,495,808, and in total it will be 2,684,000. Now product costing in non-profit organization. So non-profit organizations like universities, state hospitals, public libraries. So products are program or class of service, example an education program, research project, social welfare programs. So various department work simultaneously on a single program. For example, if the state hospital is providing a free service to a patient, then there are various departments in a state hospital. For example, the department which checks blood, the department which makes sonography, or the department which gives report. So all the departments are working together, right, for a single program. So the main challenge in this part is that it is very difficult to apply various department cost to various programs, right? Because if in a single program the program is giving free service to a customer, then every department is contributing. So it is difficult to apply cost to every department for a single person. So this is a challenge. Now product costing in service organization. For example, repair shops, consulting, legal and accounting organization. The cost driver for allocating overhead cost is often taken as direct labor cost. So whenever we are talking about service organization, the cost driver is considered as a direct labor cost. Now the budgeted overhead rate, as you know, we have seen in last PPT. Budgeted overhead, it depends on budgeted overhead and cost driver. So now in this case the cost driver is direct labor, and actual overhead will be budgeted overhead into एक्चुअल डायरेक्ट लेबर. सो एक्टिविटी बेस्ड कॉस्टिंग सिस्टम इन इज यूज्ड इन नॉन प्रॉफिट एंड सर्विस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो इन दिस केस कॉस्ट सच एज टेलीफोन कॉल्स, फोटो कॉपिंग, कंप्यूटर टाइम कैन बी मेजर टू एक्ट एज अ कॉस्ट एलोकेशन बेस. सो यू नो वट इज कॉस्ट एलोकेशन बेस. वेन एवर वी आर गोइंग टू यूज मोर देन वन कॉस्ट ड्राइवर, दैट इज नोन एज कॉस्ट एलोकेशन बेस. मेनी ओवरहेड कंपोनेंट्स कैन बी डिरेक्टली ट्रेस्ड इन स्मॉलर ओवरहेड कॉस्ट टू बी एलोकेटेड. एंड विथ एबीसी मोर प्रिसाइज कॉस्टिंग इज पॉसिबल इन केस ऑफ नॉन प्रॉफिट एंड सर्विस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो फॉर टूडे वी विल स्टॉप हियर. थैंक यू सो मच.